One day, you decided to download a game on your phone. You played it for some minutes, hours. Suddenly, you spent the whole weekend with that game. In the mall, you're playing it. Waiting for the bus, playing. At work, playing. After days and days playing, you slowly start to get bored. Then you start to realize, how did this game steal my time? Did that ever happen to you? Yes? Congratulations. You were trapped inside Skinner's box. A vast number of today's games are built upon Skinner's discoveries. The idea is to design the video game in a way that will trick your brain and make you addicted to the game, so you can't leave the game and you keep coming back again and again and again. So what is the strange story behind the Skinner box? In the early 1930s, an American man named Burrhus Frederick Skinner started to study psychology. Before him, we only knew how to condition reactions. Skinner theorized that you can go one step further. He theorized that you could condition volition, that you could change the way that people make choices. Skinner did a simple experiment. He took a pigeon and put it inside a box. The box was empty except for a button on one of its sides. When the pigeon pecked at the button, a small door opened, and a small piece of food entered the box. Skinner started watching how the pigeon behaved. At first, the pigeon was acting normally. After some time, the pigeon got hungry. It randomly pecked the button, and a few pieces of food entered the box. The pigeon ate the food, and, still hungry, looked over the box again. Then it decided to peck the button, and food entered the box a second time. Now, the pigeon is not a clever creature, but it could understand this. Pecking the button equaled food. Skinner repeated the experiment multiple times with various different animals. He came up with these conclusions. You can condition creatures to make a specific choice if you award them with a small reward, and yep, that works with humans too. This is called operant conditioning. If you award the creature each and every time after making a specific choice, it will get bored and know the lesson, and then it will stop. But if you reward it randomly and in interrupted form, like provide a reward after they perform the action a random number of times, or if there's only a reward on a set timer, it will be far more effective at conditioning someone to repeat an action. Creatures get enough satisfaction from physical needs, like sleep, food, and drink. But interpersonal needs, like wealth, compliments, and power, are unlimited in terms of satisfaction. These three conclusions made a huge revolution in many fields, like social media, marketing, and video games. Most video games use the method of random reward systems to encourage players to come back to the game and keep playing it for a long time. This is inspired by the Skinner Box experiment. The most famous and frequent method used in video games is the idea of a leveling system.
You are just at level 2! Reach level 10 to unlock that nice thing! Great! You reached level 10! Here is your thing! But if you reach level 30, you will earn that phenomenal thing! You just reached level 30! Here is your silly thing! Look at how useless it is compared to the Champion's Award you will get at level 100!
This goes on forever. This method is used by most mobile video games because it is very effective in getting players back to the game. The game doesn't have to be fun or enjoyable. All people really need is a desire for a reward. Gambling is the second method used, and because humans like challenges, in those games you have to give up some of your points for a chance to either double your points or lose it all, which is a big example of a random reward. Another method is loot or items, which will be available for a limited time, or the extra loot once every few hours, which will make you keep opening the game. However, the Skinner Box method can also add a lot of fun to some games. But some developers are taking advantage of it to make players addicted to their games. The more you play, more ads you see, or more stuff you buy from the game, which will mean more money for the developer. If you find yourself addicted to a game, ask yourself, am I playing because I enjoy the game, or because I'm just used to it? If your answer was because you're used to it, congratulations, you're inside the Skinner Box. Thank you for watching Informia.